In this video, we will try to understand how we can formulate any real-life optimization problem. Till now, we discussed about optimization, what are design variables, constraints, objective function, different types of optimization problems like discrete, continuous, linear, and non-linear, and optimization problems classification based on nature, design variables, constraints, objective function, and other. So as we discussed basic, now we will try to formulate a real life optimization problem step by step. Suppose any company who manufacture products. For simplicity and easy understanding, we have four products like candies, chocolate egg, chocolate coins, and we also need machines for manufacturing. So here we have two types of machines. And we also need workers who will help in product manufacturing. Here you can see we have two types of worker, skilled and unskilled. Suppose skilled worker can operate machines during product manufacturing process, and unskilled workers can help in product packing, delivery, and to keep products in the store. So here you can see we have a company who manufacture products. We have four products, two machines, two types of workers. Here you can see two machines, M1, M2. Each month, machine 1 is free to use for 700 hours and machine 2 is free to use for 500 hours. And here you can see here skilled, unskilled workers. Each month, company can purchase up to 600 hours of skilled workers at $8 per hour. And company can purchase 650 hours of unskilled workers at $6 per hour. So this is the maximization problem, as company want to maximize its profit. So the problem is company want to maximize its profit and calculate how much each product should be produced each month and how much labor required to purchase. So company want to determine how much labor is required and how much each product should be produced each month so that company will gain more profit. Here company profit is total revenue minus workers cost. Here in this table you can see all important details like machine time in hour, workers available in hour, and you can see here this is the unit sale price. Now we will try to formulate this problem. So here you can see the process. First we have a real life problem. So suppose this is the real life problem. Like here we want to maximize the company profit. So this is the maximization problem. Next, for this problem we will design a model. After modeling, we will formulate the problem mathematically. That is the objective function, design variables, constraints. Next, we will implement or apply existing algorithm to solve the problem. When the solution is obtained, we will check solution accuracy, we will verify it, and we will repeat this process until optimal solution is found. Now we'll start its formulation. Here we have a company who manufacture products. We have two machines and workers who helped in manufacturing process. We have skilled and unskilled workers, and company want to maximize its profit. So here we will determine how much worker required and how much each product should be produced each month so that company will gain more profit. So first we will define the variables, that is also known as design variables. So first we will decide the quantity of each product that will be manufactured. Here you can see we have variable xi, and value for I we have 1 to 4, as we have 4 products, x1, x2, x3 and x4. So here you can see we have the variables for the quantity of product that need to be manufactured, and we will also decide the number of hours for skilled and unskilled workers. So we have another two variables, one for the skilled workers, another for the unskilled worker. For skilled worker, we have variable WS, For unskilled worker, it is W, U. Now we have the variables for products X1, X2, X3, X4, and skilled worker, unskilled worker. Next, objective function that we want to maximize. So we will define the values for the variables X1, X2, X3, X4, and WS, WU. And here you can see this is the objective function. We can express the company profit using this objective function. Here you can see product 1, 2, 3, 4, X1, X2, X3, X4, 300, X1, 260, X2, 220, X3, 180, X4, and labor cost, that is 8, as skilled worker are purchased $8 per hour and unskilled $6 per hour. So company profit is equal to revenue minus workers cost. Next, we have constraints that are the restriction we will apply. Here you can see product measurement units, and here we have the time required. For first product X1, you can see here each unit of product 1 we are going to manufacture required 11 hours. So here we have 11 X1, and each unit of product 2 we are going to manufacture required 7 hours. So here we have 7 X2, and each unit of product 3 require 6 hours. So this is 6X3, and here we have, and for the fourth product we required 5 hours. So this is 5X4. So here you can see total time required on machine 1 is equal to 11X1 plus 7X2 plus 6X3 plus 5X4. Here we have one constraint. Now we will introduce the constraint, that is machine 1 time limit. As we discussed here, machine 1 is available for 700 hours each month. So this is the first constraint. The total machine time cannot exceed the 700 hours. So here the value that we will obtain should be less than 700 or equal to 700. So this is the first constraint. Same for the second machine. You can see here first product require 4 hours. So this is 4X1, second product 6 hours, that is 6X2, third product 5 hours, this is 5X3, fourth product 4 hours, this is 4X4, and for machine 2, time limit is 500, it is available for 500 hours each month. So the value that we will obtain here should be less than 500 or equal to 500. Next, we have the constraints for the workers. So once it is clear how much each product must be produced, so we will calculate amount of skilled and unskilled workers required. So make sure each type of worker must be hired for a sufficient number of hours. So here this is the constraint for the skilled worker and this one for the unskilled workers. In the last step, we will combine the objective function with the constraints, and with the constraints you can see here we have the constraint for the machines, skilled worker, unskilled workers. So here we have the objective function, and it's subject to different constraints that we already discussed in previous steps. So here we have the maximization problem. A company who manufacture products. So we have 4 products and we have 2 types of machines. Machine 1 is available for 700 hours each month, and machine 2 is available for 500 hours each month. And we have the workers who help in the product manufacturing process. We have skilled workers, unskilled workers. Company can hire skilled workers $6 per hour and unskilled workers $6 per hour. So we want to maximize the company profit, and company profit is equal to the total revenue minus workers cost. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.